Hello and welcome to Mechanical Engineering. Today in this video we are going to discuss the differences between up milling process and down milling process. So first of all we will understand the milling process. So in milling, the material is removed by rotating a cutter against the workpiece. So milling is basically a machining process in which we want to remove the material from the surface of the workpiece. And how it is removed? First of all, we have to clamp the workpiece over the table, okay? And then the cutter is rotated against the surface of the workpiece, and hence the material is get removed from the surface of the workpiece. That is nothing but the milling process. Now we can classify that milling process in two different types, the up milling and down milling. And now we are discussing the differences in between up milling process and down milling process. So for differentiating up milling process and down milling process, I have made two different columns. The first column is for up milling and second column is for down milling. Okay. And for better understanding, I have added certain images below those points. So the very first point, in up milling, the cutter rotates against the direction of table feed. So this is nothing but the up milling process. Now the cutter is shown with the help of yellow color and the workpiece is shown in green color. So you have to clamp the workpiece over the table of the machine. Okay. Now here the cutter is rotating in clockwise direction, whereas we are giving the feed to the workpiece and it is shown by the arrow. Okay. Now the cutter is rotating against the direction of the feed. And if such situation is there where the cutter is rotating against the feed direction, against the feed of the workpiece, then that process is known as up milling. Okay. So in up milling, cutter rotates against the direction of table feed. Now down milling. In down milling, cutter rotates along the direction of table feed. Now this is a down milling process. Here the cutter is rotating in clockwise direction and the feed is given towards left hand side. Okay. Now here you can see the cutter and the workpiece, they are moving in a same direction, right? And such process is known as down milling process. Okay. So in down milling, cutter rotates along the direction of table feed. So this is the major difference in between up milling and down milling. In up milling, the cutter rotates against the direction of table feed, whereas in down milling, cutter rotates along the direction of table feed. Now second difference in up milling. So chip load on the teeth or uncut chip thickness increases gradually from zero at the point of engagement to the maximum at the point of disengagement. Okay. So the chip load on the teeth or uncut chip thickness. So here you can see the up milling process. Now the chip thickness, uncut chip thickness, that is shown in blue in color. Okay. So you can see the uncut chip thickness, which is shown with the help of blue color. Now as the cutter rotates, the teeth will come in contact with the workpiece and it starts removing material from the surface of the workpiece. So this is the gradual contact. So at the point of engagement, the chip thickness will be zero and then it is increasing gradually, and at the point of disengagement, the chip thickness will be maximum. Okay. So the chip load on the teeth increases gradually from zero at the point of engagement to the maximum at the point of disengagement. As the thickness of the chip is minimum at the start, so chip load on the teeth, that is also zero at the start, and it starts increasing gradually, and at the end it is at maximum stage. Okay. So that is what written here. Chip load on the teeth or uncut chip thickness increases gradually from zero at the point of engagement to maximum at the point of disengagement. Okay. Now down milling. Chip load on the teeth or uncut chip thickness decreases gradually from maximum at the point of engagement to zero at the point of disengagement. So here you can see. So again, the uncut chip thickness, that is shown with the help of blue color. So now at the point of engagement, as the contact starts, the chip thickness is maximum. Okay, so there will be a sudden suddenly the tip of the insert will come in contact with the workpiece, and the chip thickness is maximum at the start. So the load on the insert is also maximum at the start, and it is then gradually reduces to zero. Okay, so here you can see the uncut chip thickness is maximum at the start, and then it is reducing to zero. Okay, so the chip load on the teeth or uncut chip thickness decreases gradually from maximum at the point of engagement to zero at disengagement. Now the third point. Here, tooth experiences gradual loading as the contact starts with zero chip load. Okay, so in up milling, the tooth experiences gradual loading because at the start there is a zero chip thickness. Okay, and at the end maximum chip thickness is there. So there is a gradual loading. So the tooth experiences gradual loading as the contact starts with zero chip load. Okay, so at the start there will be zero load, and that load getting increasing. Okay, so here the tooth experiences gradual loading as the contact starts with zero chip load. Now down milling. Here the tooth experiences impact loading as the tooth engages suddenly with maximum chip load. Now here what happens? Suddenly the tooth come in contact with the surface of the workpiece, and the chip load is maximum at the start. Okay, here you can see the uncut chip thickness, that is maximum at the start. So there will be maximum load at the point of engagement, and then it is starts reducing. So here the tooth experiences impact loading as the tooth engages suddenly with maximum chip load. Okay, then the next point. With horizontal axis milling machine, cutting force in up milling mode is directed upward, and thus it tends to lift off the workpiece from the work table. Accordingly, rigid and expensive fixture is required for firmly mounting the workpiece. Okay, so here you can see with this image. Now the workpiece is shown with gray color. Okay, now in up milling process, the cutter rotates against the direction of the feed. Okay, and the cutting force that is shown with the red arrow, okay, which is pointing upward. Okay, so as the cutter rotates, it will throw the chips away from the surface of the workpiece towards upward side. Okay, so the cutting force that is in upward direction. So as the cutting force is in upward direction, so it will try to lift up the workpiece from the work table. Okay, so therefore rigid and expensive fixture is required which can firmly mount in the workpiece. Okay, so basically you have to clamp the workpiece over the table, and for that the vise or some fixture is required, and as the cutting force is on the upward side, so a rigid fixture is required. Okay, otherwise what will happen? The workpiece may get removed from the fixture. So there should be a rigid fixture, which is expensive one. Okay, now in down milling. So in down milling mode, the cutting force is directed downward, and thus it tends to press the workpiece rather than lift off. So cheaper fixture can be employed. So here you can see the cutter is rotating in the same direction. Okay, so the cutting force is downward. Now it will try to press the workpiece. Okay, so in up milling what happened? It will try to lift up the workpiece, whereas in down milling it is trying to press the workpiece. So in this case we can use a cheaper fixture. Okay, as the cutting force is in downward direction, so we can use a cheaper fixture. Now the next difference. Thin workpiece sample, if machine using up milling mode, may get distorted due to upward cutting force. Okay, so as we have discussed earlier, the cutting force is in upward direction, so it will try to lift up the workpiece, right? And if the thickness of the workpiece is less, in that case it may get distorted due to upward cutting force. Now in down milling, Chances of distortion of thin workpiece sample are less with down milling mode if proper support in the bottom is provided. Okay, so in down milling process, the cutting force is in downward direction. So there are less chances of getting distorted workpiece. Only the thing is, we have to support the workpiece properly because the cutting force is in downward direction. So there should be a rigid support at the bottom. Next point, due to gradual buildup of chip load in up milling, heat generation is also high. So there exists a tendency of chip welding with the teeth. Okay, so as there is a gradual loading. Now here you can see, this is nothing but the tip of the insert which is in contact with the workpiece. As there is a gradual loading, so the cutting insert is in contact with the chip. So there is a friction in between the surface of the insert and the chip, and due to that friction, heat generation will be there. And as the heat is generated, the chip may get welded to the tip of the insert. Okay, so here you can see the built up edge deposit on the chip, then built up edge. Okay, even the built up edge on the machine surface. So this is nothing but the formation of built up edges. And this may happen in up milling process due to gradual loading. So due to gradual buildup of chip load in up milling, heat generation is also high. So there exists a tendency of chip welding with the teeth. So the chip may get welded to the tip of the insert. Now in down milling, tendency of the chip welding is less in down milling, but chip redeposition on the finished surface occurs frequently that may degrade the quality of finished surface. Okay, so here this is a down milling process. So the chips are thrown away during the machining process. Okay, so whatever chips produce, they are thrown away over the machine surface. Suppose these are the chips and they get deposited over the machine surface, right? So the tendency of chip welding is less in down milling, but chip get redeposited on the machine surface and that may degrade the quality of machine surface. So that is the disadvantage of down milling process. So both the process have disadvantage. In up milling process, the disadvantage is built up edge due to heat generation, whereas in down milling process, the chip may get redeposited over the machined surface, so it may degrade the quality of the machined surface. Now the next difference, burr is formed only on the unfinished surface ahead of the tool feed. However, majority of such burr is removed in subsequent passes. Okay. In down milling, burr is formed at the finished surface in opposite side of the tool feed. Thus, these burr are not removed automatically. This lead to degrade the cutting quality. Okay, so here I have shown the burr with the help of this image. Here you can see the burr. Okay, in the milling process. Now we will understand this point in clear manner. So up milling process, burr is formed only on the unfinished surface ahead of the tool feed. However, majority of such burr is removed in subsequent passes. Okay, now this is up milling process. Now the burr is formed. Okay, burr is formed on the unmachined surface. So in up milling process, what happened? In up milling process, the burr may form here. Okay, the burr may form here and in subsequent passes. Okay, now this insert will come in contact, and when it will come in contact, it will remove this burr. Okay, so that is what written in that point. The burr is formed only on the unfinished surface ahead of the tool feed. However, majority of such burr is removed in the subsequent passes. Okay, so whatever the burr left over the unfinished surface, that will get removed in the subsequent passes in up milling process. Now we will understand the down milling. Burr is formed at the finished surface in the opposite side of the tool feed. Thus, these burr are not removed automatically. This leads to degrade the cutting quality. Now in down milling process, the burr will form here. Okay, and As the cutting takes place, this insert will not come in contact with the machine surface. It will come in contact with the unmachined surface only. Okay, so the burr may left over the machine surface, and this will degrade the quality of workpiece or the cutting surface. Okay, so what is written? Burr is formed at the finished surface in opposite side of the tool feed. Thus, these burr are not removed automatically. You have to remove that burr. Okay, and this will lead to degrade the cutting quality. Now the next point, at the beginning of engagement, teeth rub with lay or feed marks on the machine surface. This improves the surface finish. In down milling, no such rubbing action takes place, and thus lay mark remains intact on the machine surface. So here with this image, I have shown the lay marks or the feed marks of the cutting inserts over the surface of the milled surface. Okay, so what is written in up milling? At the beginning of engagement, teeth rub with the lay or feed marks on the machined surface. This improves the surface finish. Okay, so with this we will understand this point. Now this teeth, okay, so this teeth will produce feed marks or lay marks over the machine surface, and after that this insert will come in contact with the machine surface. So whatever the feed mark produced by this teeth, whatever the feed mark produced by this teeth over the machine surface, that will get removed by this tip. Okay, so ultimately, due to rubbing of this teeth over the machine surface, the feed mark or lay mark produced by the insert, that will get removed, and it increases the surface finish. Okay, so this happens in up milling. Okay, so again I will clear this point. So now the rubbing action takes place. Okay, due to rubbing, the feed mark will produce over here over the machine surface. Now again this insert will come in contact with the machine surface, right? And whatever feed mark produced by this insert, suppose this is insert 1 and this is insert 2, so the feed mark produced by insert 1 over the machine surface, that will get removed by the second insert. Okay, and that is what written in that point. So at the beginning of engagement, teeth rub with the lay or feed mark on the machine surface, and this improves the surface finish. Now in down milling, no such rubbing action takes place, and thus lay mark remains intact on the machine surface. Okay, now this is a down milling process. Now suppose this is insert 1 and this one is insert 2. Now the feed mark produced by this insert 1, suppose these are the feed marks which is on the machine surface by insert 1. Now as the cutter rotate, the second insert will come in contact, but that second insert will not come in contact with the machine surface. So whatever the feed mark produced by insert 1, that will left over there. Okay, and that will degrade the quality of machine surface, right? So no such rubbing action takes place, and thus lay mark remains intact on the machine surface. So rubbing action is not takes place in down milling, and hence the lay mark produced by the inserts remain intact on the machine surface, and that degrades the quality of the workpiece. Now the next point, besides improving surface finish, rubbing during the engagement may result in undesirable work hardening owing to significant heat generation. Okay, as the rubbing action takes place in up milling process, due to rubbing action there is a friction. Okay, and due to friction, heat will be generated, and as the heat generates over there, that will change the microstructure of the workpiece, and it increases the hardness. Okay, so that is what written over here. Besides improving the surface finish, rubbing during the engagement may result in undesirable work hardening. So undesirably, you are increasing the hardness of the workpiece, right? So work hardening is takes place in up milling process. Now down milling, chances of work hardening is minimal with down milling, as there is no rubbing action, so there will be no heat generation, so there are minimum chances of work hardening in down milling. The last point, In upmilling mode, no chipping action occurs on the teeth of the cutting tool due to gradual contact. Accordingly, tool wear rate is relatively low. So as there is a gradual load, so there will be no chipping action over the insert. Okay, if there is a sudden contact, in that case, chipping action is there. So if there is a sudden contact, due to sudden load over the tip of the workpiece, it may get break. Okay, so in upmilling mode, no chipping action occurs on the teeth of the cutting tool due to gradual contact. Accordingly, tool wear rate is low. So you will be getting good tool life in upmilling process as there is a gradual loading. Now in downmilling, due to impact load at the engagement, chipping occurs and it may cause notch wear. Thus, the tool wear rate is high. There also exists a chance of catastrophic failure of the teeth. So as there is a sudden contact in between the insert and the surface of the workpiece, okay, suddenly you are applying the load over the tip of the cutting tool. So it may break the tip of the cutting tool. Okay, it may break the tip of the insert, and that is nothing but a catastrophic failure. Okay, and there is a greater chances of catastrophic failure in downmilling process due to impact loading, whereas in upmilling process there is a gradual loading, so you will be getting good tool life, and tool life is very important in machining process. So I hope you have understood the difference between upmilling and downmilling process. So thank you so much for watching my video. Thank you.